Hey guys, welcome to Pursuit Kids Online. We are so excited that you're joining us this morning. I'm Miss Irene.
And I'm Miss Carrie, and it's my most favorite time of the day. It's time to worship. So get ready to stand to your feet, get ready to lift your hands and dance with us, because worship starts now.
We won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. redeemed by his grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. Cause we were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by his grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise.
There's joy in the house.
There is joy in this house.
Preschoolers, this week we're going to learn the story of how David spared Saul's life while hiding in a cave. So get ready because your video starts now.
It's Kelly!
Hey!
What are we going to do today? We're going to learn and play.
Okay.
Sing a song and pray.
That's right.
God really loves us. God really, really cares about you, me, our families.
That's right.
God's always right there.
No,
if we can't get this right, how are we ever going to get people to listen to our new singing group? Hey, friends. Chip and I decided to start a singing group together.
Yeah, we're called One Squirrel and One Girl.
We thought it was a cool name because...
It's what we are.
Because we are one squirrel and one girl.
Living in harmony.
We did it again. What's going on?
I think you're supposed to be singing ah.
I think you're singing ah when you should be singing ah. And that's not right. Ugh, if we can't even sing together, maybe we can't be a band. Goodbye, One Squirrel and One Girl.
Oh, that makes me sad. I mean, we're singing about living in harmony, which means like being together and getting along. But we're not doing that.
No, we're not. Harmony is important for singing and for friendships. Let's see if our Bible story for today can help.
It's time for today's Bible story, and it comes from 1 Samuel chapter 24. Out of anger and jealousy, King Saul was hunting David. One day, as Saul and his men were looking, they came to a cave. Saul went into the cave to take a rest. Little did he know, David and his men were actually hiding in that same cave. Saul had no idea. David snuck up on Saul without being seen. But instead of hurting Saul, he cut off a corner of Saul's clothing. After this, David felt bad about doing that. The reason he felt bad was because Saul was once God's chosen king. Even with Saul wanting to hurt him, David did not want to do anything to hurt Saul. Saul left the cave and David called out to him, "Why do you believe that I want to hurt you? I had the chance to hurt you in the cave. I cut a piece of your clothing, but I didn't hurt you. But you are hunting me down and want to kill me. God will decide what happens next, and I hope God will save me from you." Saul felt so bad and began to cry. He said, David, you are a better person than I am. I've treated you badly, but you haven't done anything to hurt me. Even when God gave you the chance to, I hope God gives you many good things knowing that you have treated me well today. Please make a promise to God and to me that you will not hurt my family. So David made that promise to Saul. Saul and David chose peace and harmony with each other that day. They chose not to hurt each other. Saul went back home and they were able to live in harmony. We may not get along with others around us, but God can help us live peacefully with others. When we are faced with choices like David and Saul were in the story, let us pray. God, help us live in harmony.
God, help us live in harmony.
Amen. You know, Chip, I think I was singing, ah, when I should have been singing, ah.
Now that I think about it, I could sing a little more like, ah, and that might sound better.
Let's try it. Cause we are one squirrel and one girl living in harmony. We did it!
Yeah, we did!
I'm glad we heard that Bible story before we gave up on our cool new band.
Me too. With just a little more practice, I think we'll be ready to put on a concert for thousands of people around the world.
Or just singing for our families.
And then, around the world.
Yeah! Who's gonna stop us? Chip, I'm really glad that we're not arguing anymore.
Me too, Callie. I know friends don't get along sometimes, but I learned from the Bible story that it's up to us to be kind to each other.
That's right! So next time we start to squabble, we need to remember to stop and pray. God, help us live in harmony. It's been fun learning and growing with you, friends.
It was fun making music with you, Callie. I can't wait to make our first one squirrel and one girl music video.
Ooh, that would be awesome. Gotta get to work, friends. Peace out.
Hey guys, today in elementary, we're gonna talk about how God helps us live in harmony. So get ready, because your video starts now.
Hey Emma, have you ever received an award for anything?
Sure.
What was your favorite?
Perfect attendance in grade school. I kept that award up on a shelf. I was so proud. How about you?
Similar.
Really?
Yeah, I ate lunch at Taco World every single day in the month of May.
You got an award for that?
Oh yeah, a free taco. And I kept it on my shelf. I was so proud. And then I ate it. Jay, welcome to Press Play.
Hey Jay, what made you ask about receiving an award?
Oh, well, as you know, we've been pressing play and taking our band Emma, or Jay, and the Stray Cats and going more than global. I was just thinking, what if we won some kind of award?
Cool, that would be cool.
Incredibly cool. Hey, it's my grandma, or it could be Miss Business if she's calling as our band manager. Hey grandma.
Nope, Miss Business. Guess what, kids? I need you both to gear up and hit the press play button right away. Not sure how that button works, but hopefully it will bring you to the red carpet because we just won the award for the best new band featuring Cats in the Galaxy.
No way! Was there anyone else even in that category?
You'd be surprised, but we pulled it out. Now, you better pick out your best cat sweaters and decide who's going to have the guts to give this acceptance speech. Press play and get here. Miss Business, out.
Yeah, I never thought about who should give the acceptance speech.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it should be you, because you're you.
Yeah, but it was Emma and the Stray Cats first, so maybe you better do it.
But if I remember right, the whole band thing was kind of your idea, so...
Are you serious?
Yeah, you should be the one to do it.
No, I think you should be the one to do it.
I guess we'll let the press play button decide.
Fine.
3, 2, 1, press play!
Where's Emma?
Jay! Oh my goodness, you made it! The cats are here, we gotta go! The award is about to be announced. Where's Emma?
Well, I don't know, I ended up here, but she, I don't know.
Now, did you guys decide who was gonna give the acceptance speech?
No, we didn't. We actually kind of got into a little back and forth about that before we pressed play. And now we're here and Emma could totally do the speech if she wanted.
Oh my goodness. Okay, well, Miss Business, your band manager, wants to tell you to move your buns. But as your grandma, I gotta say, this reminds me of a Bible story from 1 Samuel 24.
Oh, Grandma. Yeah. It does?
Yeah, it sure does. Okay, because of King Saul's jealousy, he and David were always at odds with each other. Mm. Each had armies of men fighting for them. One day, as Saul and his men were out hunting David, Saul went into a cave to take a little restroom break.
Okay, well, no offense, Grandma. Other than them fighting, I'm not really tracking the connection here.
Okay, well, Grandma would say, it's coming, sweetie. But Miss Business says, hold on to your trousers, son, and don't you dare sass me.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now little did Saul know that David and his men were in that very cave where he was going to go to the bathroom. Saul was all alone. David's men thought this was the perfect time for David to end this fight once and for all.
I get it. Kind of like this opportunity I have to give this speech when Emma's not here.
Right. Now, Miss Business says to zip it so that I can finish the story. Okay. David's men were right. This was David's chance. But 1 Samuel 24:3 says, then David crept up unnoticed and he cut off a corner of Saul's robe.
A corner of his robe.
Yeah, a corner of his robe. And afterward, David felt bad about even doing that. He confronted Saul and showed him the piece of his robe. He told him that he had the chance to end this fight, but well, he didn't do it. Mm. He couldn't do it because he didn't want to do it. Okay, he didn't want the fight to end that way. He wanted harmony between them. Mm. Saul couldn't believe that David didn't take that opportunity to do him any harm, especially with how bad Saul had been to him. Saul was jealous of David because he knew God had chosen him as king. Mm. You know, so he said to David in verse 20 and 21, he said, I know that you will surely be king and that the kingdom of Israel will be established in your hands. Mm. Now swear to me by the Lord that you will not kill off my descendants or wipe out my name from my father's family. David promised that he wouldn't lay a finger on Saul or his family. Now, Jay, you know your grandma's not much of a singer, but goodness, hearing about you and Emma fighting over who's going to give this speech, it makes me want to sing this prayer.
Oh.
Here I go. God, help us live in harmony. Oh, my goodness, that triggered the BID alarm. Well, who's going to do the speech?
Well, it's all good, Grandma.
Oh.
Now, press play handshake.
You got it.
Woo!
Yeah!
Oh, there you are. I didn't go anywhere. Someday we really have to figure out this button and all of its quirks. So, who gave the speech? Did you do it?
Yeah, I had to figure it out for my friend, but I didn't give that speech alone.
Who helped?
Well, I bet my grandma posted it. Let's see.
And the award for Best New Band featuring cats in the whole galaxy goes to Emma and Jay and the Stray Cats. Woohoo! Meow.
Perfect! Wow, Jay, that was really cool of you.
Well, when we pressed play, I went to the red carpet. I had the chance to give the speech with my grandma, or Miss Business, our manager. She shared the story of David and Saul from 1 Samuel chapter 24. David had the chance to end their fight in a really bad way, but God help them to live harmoniously together, at least for the time being. I wanted to do the same thing with my best friend. God really does help us live in harmony. How can you make the decision to live in harmony with someone? Now it's time to
drop the verse!
I can't wait to drop this verse!
Oh, if you got a harp, get it out now!
Get it out right now if you got a harp! Here we go!
Sing to the Lord with grateful praise, make music to our God. Sing to the Lord with grateful praise, make music to our God on the harp. Psalm 147, 7. Psalm 147, 7. Sing to the Lord with grateful praise, make music to our God on the harp. Psalm 147, 7.
147.
Sing to the Lord with grateful praise. Make music to our God on the horn.
Hey guys, I hope you had so much fun worshiping with us that you learned something new from your Bible stories.
Yep, and don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any updates from Pursuit Kids Online. We love you guys and we'll see you next week.
Bye guys. Yeah.